Hi, this is KETV, and I'm Julius Rosario. Here today at the Thames, we are here to talk about an endangered species called the enigmatic eel. With marine life in the Thames slowly declining, certain issues have to be looked at as to why this is happening. Some may look towards global warming, climate change, and so forth. I decided to go to Kingston University to interview Dr. Kerr about marine life and the decline of the enigmatic eel. Dr. Kerr, what is the enigmatic eel, its main characteristics and its main habitat?
Well, eels are elongate bony fishes which lack pelvic fins. Their dorsal fin and their anal fins are continuous with the tail fin, and this, together with very small eyes, gives them a rather snake-like appearance. They're very enigmatic because they are very secretive in their habits, and we don't know a lot about the aspects of their biology. We know that they live for most of their lives in freshwater and return to sea to spawn, but as I say, there's not a lot known about them. My main interests are European eels, Anguilla anguilla.
What is the life cycle of the enigmatic eel?
Well, as far as we know, eels spawn in the vicinity of the Sargasso Sea, which is near Bermuda. The larvae which hatch from eggs float in ocean currents to European shores. And when they get near to estuaries, they transform into glass eels, or elvers, which migrate upstream. Now, there is a theory that male eels tend to live in rivers and estuarine conditions, whereas females live in lakes. They're a lot larger. Whatever is the case, they feed as yellow eels for about 6 to 12 years, and then they start to go a silver colour, and then the silver eels return to sea to spawn.
What is causing the decline of the enigmatic eel?
Well, there are thought to be a number of factors responsible for this. The most obvious is overfishing of eels. Eels are exploited at all stages of their life cycle. The elvers are fished out for food as elver cakes and also for use in growing on farms. The yellow and silver eels are fished out directly for consumption. So this is a big problem. Of course, as I've said, there are other factors as well, such as pollution and parasites, such as the pathogenic swim bladder nematode Anguillica crassus. And of course, ocean currents have changed between Europe and the Sargasso Sea. That could also be having an effect. In addition, there may be many barriers to upstream migration, such as dams, weirs, and locks, which may be hindering the eel migration to fresh waters.
What impact does the decline of the eel have on the food chain of other fishes?
Well, eels are keystone species in freshwater ecosystems. They form a valuable food source for otters, which are on the return, and herons and bitterns as well.
Are there any EU regulations to safeguard eel fisheries or to regulate the use of chemicals?
The European Commission are well aware that eel stocks are not within sustainable limits, and they are putting together a management strategy to try to conserve eel stocks in Europe. For the time being, they're asking for national policies to reduce overfishing of eels at all stages of their life cycle. They're also asking for improvements in water quality and also for measures to stop hindering upstream migration of eels. So Britain, for example, is putting in eel passes. They're little sort of eel ladders that the eels can use to get round an obstruction, such as a lock.
In the River Thames, are there other fishes that are in danger of radical decline?
Actually, this is, I'd say, to the contrary. In the 1950s, the River Thames was declared biologically dead. But improvements in water quality due to reduction in thermal and organic pollution have brought fish back to the Thames. In the last research project, which I carried out with the Environment Agency, we found 122 species of fish now in the Thames, and that's increasing all the time.
Finally, in your opinion, do you think the enigmatic eel will be extinct if the decline continues in this trend?
In my opinion, yes, the eel will become extinct. However, there are now great improvements in the way that we induce eels to spawn in captivity. Now, this work is still in the early stages, but I believe that eel farming will be the saviour of the enigmatic eel.
Thank you, Dr. Cott.
Thank you, Julius.
Keeping all the facts in mind, certain actions must be taken. For if societies don't find alternative means to change our extravagant ways, environmental habitats for both humans and marine life will both have catastrophic effects and consequences. For the enigmatic eel, it may be too late. But for the rest of the marine life, we may still have time. Until then, the future is up to us. This is Julius Rosario, standing down for KUTV.